What's up, everyone? My name is Soren Iverson, and I'm a product designer currently working at Cash App. Today, I'm going to walk you through five of the Figma plugins that I use on a daily basis. These tools help me save time and design more efficiently. The plugins I'm going to share can help your workflow regardless of what type of design you do. Let's dive in. If you've never used a Figma plugin before, think of it as an app within Figma. You can use a plugin for accessibility help, sourcing icons, creating placeholder text, removing photo backgrounds, and so much more. You can explore, research, and install Figma plugins in the community section of the app. From here, you can either look at some of the most popular plugins on Figma or find a specific one. Figma also has a list called New Plugins and Widgets, where they curate some of the most popular plugins on their platform. If you click on the detail page of a Figma plugin, you'll see the title, the name of the creator, how many people have liked it, how many people have installed it, tags, and a brief description of how it works. If you scroll down, you can also see other plugins that have been created by this person, version history, as well as any updates that have been made to the app, as well as comments. If you have something that you want the creator to change, or maybe there's a bug, you can easily report that here. Now that you have a better understanding of how Figma plugins work, let's take a look at some of the plugins that I use every day. Iconduck started as an open source website with thousands of vector icons that you could really easily download. If I'm working on a UX project or something that needs a simple icon like settings, I can easily find the right one, download it, and add it to my Figma. The Iconduck Figma plugin lets you actually search for something within the app without ever having to leave it. So if I go to plugins, find more plugins, type in Iconduck, and if I run it, you can see I type in settings, hit enter, searches, and then I can quickly grab an icon, click, and you'll see it's added to my Figma file. This comes in handy for anything from settings to money to people. There are almost 120,000 icons on the Iconduck app, so you should be able to find almost anything you want. Another plugin that I regularly use is called Smoothshadow. It's great for creating and customizing beautiful drop shadows. It's pretty easy to create a drop shadow within Figma, but Smoothshadow lets you layer multiple shadows on top of each other at the same time. If I take a new layer, go to Plugins, click Find More Plugins, find Smoothshadow, and click Run, you'll see a couple things. I can change the color of the shadow, I can adjust how many layers it has, the alpha, which will change how intense the shadow is, offset, which changes the vertical position, as well as blur, which can make the shadow either more or less defined. Once I click apply, you'll see that it's actually created six different shadows here in order to get this more nuanced effect that you're seeing. This example is pretty extreme and wouldn't often be used in actual UI, but I use Smoothshadow a lot in both presentations and when I'm creating mockups in Figma. Another plugin I use pretty regularly is Lore. If any of you have ever had to work with filler text, Lore is something that would really speed up your workflow. Lore is a plugin that I like to use when I'm trying to get lorem ipsum text into a project. When I first started designing, I had to constantly use lipsum.com on a tab in my browser. Thanks to Lore, I don't have to do this anymore. Instead of copying and pasting text from the web, all I have to do is select the text layer, open Lore, and choose my settings. For example, if I do something like this, let's make it a little smaller so we'll be able to see this when I generate my results. So what I will do is I will have this text layer selected, and then I'll click on plugins, search for Lore, and it's right here. So I'll run it, and I'm gonna add three sentences, and I'll click add. I went ahead and resized this, but as you can see, I was able to really quickly generate three sentences of filler text without ever having to leave Figma. One of the things I like about Lore is that you can do words, sentences, or paragraphs rather than just copying and pasting a paragraph and having to trim it down. I work in financial technology, so pretty often I'm working with graphs and data visualization. Sparkliner is one of the plugins that I really like using when I need to create a quick graph. Let's go to a new layer. Go to plugins, find more plugins, type Sparkliner, we'll run it. And here you'll get a window that has a few different things. You've got a preview of the graph, you've got the size that it's going to be, the margins of the chart, the look and feel, which is dotted or not, and then smooth or not, and then any data that you would have associated with this chart. So let's make this a 500 by 500, and then we'll change the margins to be 40 on each side. We're gonna remove the dots for this time, and we're gonna keep it smooth. I don't really like the look of this chart, so let's hit shuffle until we get something that we like this. So I'm gonna click create, and as you can see, I have a new chart here. Let's say I wanna change the color, I can really easily do that, and I can also change the thickness of the strokes for this chart. The last plugin that I'm gonna show you, and this is one that I probably use the most out of any, is a plugin called Autoflow. Autoflow is great to show how one screen or one interaction flows into the next. If I take two layers here and I wanna connect them, what I would do is click plugins, and more plugins, I search Autoflow, and I click run. If I click on this layer here, hold the shift key and then click on another layer, Autoflow will automatically create a line that points from one to the next. Let's say I'm not happy with how this visually looks. What I can do is I can change the color here. Let's have this be just black. Let's make the stroke a little bit thinner. And let's have this be no terminal rather than an open terminal. If I click on this layer and then click on this layer, you'll see I can get a different type of connecting arrow here. This is a really helpful way to show how flows work when you're sharing them with product managers, developers, or even other designers. Those are five of the plugins that I use most regularly, but there are so many more if you explore the Figma community. Thanks so much for watching, and if you haven't already, like and subscribe. I'm Soren, and I'll see you in the next video.